For the FDIC, they're really focused on trying to replenish this deposit insurance fund without charging the nation's smallest bank.
Open accounts at different banks. So in practice, you will have a savings account that is insured up to $250,000 at Bank A.
The global economy relies heavily on the banking sector, which is currently facing significant challenges. Recent events have sent shockwaves in financial markets and raised doubts about the stability of our banking system. Statements by Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen have sparked much debate and concern, especially regarding the security of bank assets and the role of FDIC insurance. And the sudden expansion of coverage has left many people questioning the true state of our financial institutions. Understanding Yellen's controversial statements and FDIC insurance. In a recent interview with ABC News, Janet Yellen made comments that have sparked controversy. She implied that the income generated by assets held in financial institutions belongs to the institution rather than the asset owner. This suggests that the financial benefits obtained from individual deposits might not belong to the depositor, but to the bank. Yellen's remarks have raised important questions about the nature of asset ownership and the legal and ethical implications of such a position. Yellen's statement, "The interest that your savings account generates is actually not yours to keep," has major implications. If taken literally, it could suggest that banks have a right to the earnings from deposited funds, justifying the seizure of these assets under certain conditions. This perspective is concerning as it challenges the conventional understanding of individual ownership and financial security. Implications of Yellen's statements. If taken literally, Yellen's statements could create a dangerous precedent. In legal terms, the institution holding a deposited asset would own the income it generates rather than the individual who owns the original asset. This line of reasoning could undermine individuals' confidence in the financial system. If the interest or earnings from savings accounts are not considered personal property, it might make you worry about the security of your deposits. This could lead to broader concerns about the safety of your money in different accounts at a bank or other financial institutions. Understanding FDIC insurance. In light of these concerns, it is very important to understand how the FDIC insurance works. Established in 1933 following the Great Depression to restore trust in the American banking system, their primary function is to insure deposits in banks, providing a safety net for depositors if a bank fails. The FDIC insures deposits up to $250,000 per depositor per insured bank for each account ownership category. This coverage includes traditional checking and savings accounts, money market deposit accounts, and certificates of deposit. However, it's important to understand what FDIC insurance does not cover. It doesn't protect investments such as stocks, bonds, mutual funds, life insurance policies, and annuities. The seizure of bank assets. What happened? In a move that caught many by surprise, federal regulators recently seized the assets of several banks across the United States. This drastic action is typically reserved for institutions on the brink of failure, raising alarm bells throughout the financial sector. While not among the largest in the country, the banks in question were significant players in their regional markets. Their sudden downfall has sent ripples through local economies and beyond. Small businesses, which often rely heavily on regional banks for loans and other financial services, have been particularly hard hit. The reasons behind these seizures are complex and multifaceted. Initial reports suggest a combination of risky investment strategies, poor management decisions, and exposure to volatile market sectors. While each bank's situation is unique, a common thread seems to be an overexposure to long-term treasury bonds. As interest rates rose rapidly over the past year, the value of these bonds plummeted, leaving the banks with significant unrealized losses on their balance sheets. The FDIC's expanded coverage, a sign of deeper troubles. Perhaps the most startling development in this unfolding drama is the sudden and dramatic expansion of FDIC deposit insurance coverage. Traditionally, it extends up to $250,000 per bank, per depositor. However, this limit has been temporarily lifted for the affected institutions in light of recent events. This unprecedented move raises several important questions. Some analysts view the expanded coverage as necessary to prevent a full-blown banking crisis. By reassuring depositors that their funds are safe, regulators hope to prevent a devastating bank run that could spread to other institutions. However, critics argue that this move sets a dangerous precedent. They worry that it could encourage risky behavior by banks, who might assume they'll be bailed out if things go wrong. There are also concerns about the moral hazard of protecting wealthy depositors who should have been more diligent about diversifying their assets. Maximizing FDIC coverage. To safeguard your deposits, there are several strategies you can employ to maximize your FDIC insurance coverage. Spread your deposits across multiple banks. By opening accounts at different banks, you can ensure that each account is insured up to the FDIC limit. For instance, having a savings account at Bank A and a money market account at Bank B will provide $250,000 of coverage for each account. Utilize different ownership categories. The FDIC provides insurance coverage based on ownership categories. To maximize coverage, you can open accounts in various ownership structures. Common ownership categories include single accounts owned by one person, including checking accounts, savings accounts, and business accounts for sole proprietors. Joint accounts owned by two or more people. Each co-owner is insured up to $250,000, resulting in $500,000 coverage for a joint account. There are also trust accounts, which can be revocable or irrevocable. The FDIC provides insurance based on the beneficiaries named in the trust. Open accounts in multiple ownership categories. By diversifying your account ownership, you can increase your FDIC coverage. For example, a married couple could each have individual and joint accounts, providing multiple layers of insurance coverage. Steps to protect your assets. Given the current financial situation and Janet Yellen's recent statements, it is important to take steps to protect your assets. Diversify your holdings. Don't keep all your money in one bank or one type of account. Spread your assets across various banks and account types to maximize insurance coverage. Stay informed. Keep up with financial news and understand how changes in policy might affect your deposits. Consult financial advisors. If you're unsure about the best strategies to protect your assets, consider consulting a financial advisor who can provide personalized advice based on your financial situation. The root causes, examining the underlying issues. To fully understand the current crisis, we must look beyond the immediate events and examine the underlying issues plaguing the banking sector. Low interest rate environment. Years of near zero interest rates have encouraged banks to take on more risk in search of higher returns. Regulatory rollbacks. The easing of certain banking regulations in recent years has allowed some institutions to engage in riskier practices. Technological disruption. Traditional banks are facing increasing competition from fintech companies, pushing them to adopt more aggressive strategies. Economic uncertainty. The ongoing impact of the events of 2020, as well as geopolitical tensions, have created a volatile economic environment. Concentration of assets. Many banks have become overly reliant on a narrow range of assets, leaving them vulnerable to market shifts. The ripple effects, impact on the broader economy. The seizure of bank assets and the ensuing uncertainty are not isolated events. Their impact is being felt across the economy in various ways. With banks becoming more cautious, access to credit for businesses and individuals has become more difficult. Stricter lending standards mean fewer loans are approved, and those often come with higher interest rates and more stringent conditions. This can hinder the ability of businesses to expand and individuals to make significant purchases, such as homes and cars. The financial sector's troubles have led to increased volatility in stock markets, affecting investors large and small. Fluctuations in stock prices can damage investment portfolios, leading to decreased wealth and increased anxiety among investors. This volatility can also make it harder for companies to raise capital through the stock market, further stifling economic growth. A lack of faith in the banking system could reduce consumer spending and economic activity. When consumers are uncertain about the safety of their deposits and the overall health of financial institutions, they are more likely to save rather than spend. This reduction in spending can slow down economic growth, as consumer spending is a significant driver of the economy. The banking crisis could cool down the real estate market as mortgage lending tightens. Higher borrowing costs and stricter lending criteria can make it more difficult for homebuyers to secure mortgages. This can lead to a slowdown in home sales and a decline in property values, affecting homeowners and investors in the real estate market. If the banking sector contracts, it could lead to job losses not only in finance, but also in related industries. Banks play a crucial role in providing capital and financial services to businesses. A contraction in the banking sector can reduce the availability of these services, leading to reduced business activity, and consequently, job cuts across various sectors that rely on bank financing and services. policy responses and solutions. In response to recent financial challenges and concerns over banking stability, several key initiatives are being discussed to strengthen oversight and safeguard the financial system. One critical area of focus is the call for stricter regulation of banks, especially mid-sized institutions, that have been overlooked. The aim is to close regulatory gaps and ensure that all banks adhere to robust standards to prevent future crises. Simultaneously, there is a growing consensus on banks' need for more rigorous and frequent stress testing. These stress tests are crucial in identifying vulnerabilities before they escalate into full-blown financial emergencies. By conducting comprehensive stress tests, regulators can proactively address weak points and implement corrective measures to fortify the banking sector. Recognizing the importance of liquidity in maintaining financial stability, the Federal Reserve has introduced new lending programs. These initiatives are designed to provide banks with additional liquidity support, bolstering their ability to effectively weather economic downturns and unforeseen shocks. Another area under scrutiny is deposit insurance reform, with ongoing debates about restructuring the FDIC system. The goal is to enhance depositor protection while minimizing moral hazard, ensuring that banks operate responsibly without relying on government bailouts. Moreover, proposals are being considered to heighten executive accountability within banks. There is a push to hold bank executives more responsible for risky decisions contributing to bank failures. Strengthening executive accountability aims to promote prudent risk management practices and discourage reckless behavior that could jeopardize financial stability. The seizure of bank assets, conflicting statements from Janet Yellen, and the expansion of FDIC coverage have put the banking sector under intense scrutiny and uncertainty. These events have revealed vulnerabilities in our financial system and raised important questions about regulation, risk management, and the government's role in banking. Dealing with these challenges will require a balance of regulation, innovation, and transparency from financial institutions and government.